What's going on, everybody? I'm Patrick from POWLAX, and in this video, we've got another great drill that I learned from Coach Minshall called the Mammoth Shooting Drill. And so this drill is going to focus on breakaway shooting as well as how we are going to make exchanges through the box. And unlike the Salmon Bellies drill, I think I have a pretty good idea about where this name comes from, considering I'm in Colorado and our NLL team is called the Mammoth. Big shout out to everyone who let me know why the Salmon Bellies drill is called Salmon Bellies. There is a club up in New Westminster, British Columbia called the Salmon Bellies, and they have won a few Senior A Canadian championships. So big thank you to everyone who let me know, because it's cool to know where these names are coming from. As with every new video, if you'd like to download the playbook PDF of this drill for your playbook, you can get that at patreon.com/powlax by clicking this link up here or the link down in the description. We recently passed 50 patrons. I think we're at 55 now. So big thank you to everyone who has been supporting on Patreon. I really hope that you enjoy those PDFs. Now let's get into the drill. The first thing that we're going to talk about is the setup. And the first thing we're going to do to set up the drill is we're going to put a ton of balls in the off bench corners, both corners. Then we're going to have all of the players and coaches go to the benches, and they are going to line up as if it's either the first or third period, meaning that they are going to leave their bench, move across the midline, and shoot on the opposite goal. Or it could be the second period, in which they would line up on the opposite ends. When we ran it with the Hawks, we actually ran it as if it was the second period, but I'm going to show you the first and third period first. And so a quick note about having the coaches on the benches. I really recommend having coaches on the benches. If you have four, which is probably pretty doubtful, have them at each door so that they can then open and shut the doors for the players. If you don't have coaches at the benches, but you will have them at the games, you can definitely just leave the doors open, considering we don't have any worry about people falling into the benches because we're not actually playing live. But then if you are not going to have coaches at both doors during games, I really recommend shutting the doors and making the players open them, and really making sure all of the players understand the idea that they don't actually have to get into the bench prior to the other player leaving. They just need to basically step to the wall where the door is, and then the other player can leave. Now we're going to get into running the drill, and as I am drawing it, I'm actually going to focus on the player who is cutting and finishing first, and then we'll go over what the feeder is going to do, because it'll give us a good understanding of exactly how it's going to work, where I don't have to talk about one player than the other all the time. So we're going to run this to both sides at the same time, but I'm just going to talk about this half first, then this half. So to start the drill, D3 is going to leave the bench, come across midfield. He is going to accept a pass from D2, and then he is going to finish on cage. Once he has finished on cage, he is then going to come and he's going to replace this player who had just fed him the ball. Now this player who just fed him the ball, right after he throws it, he is going to interpret that he is now leaving his own defensive end, which is a little weird because he's going to sub to his own box. As he is subbing to the box, he's going to yell, one, 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 letting the player who is in the front of this line know, okay, one person has to go. Now, if we had this drill run with more players, the second player would come and he would yell two, as far as moving from defense to offense within an actual live box game. Once he comes off the floor, D4 is then going to cut across this way. He is going to receive a feed from R3, catch it, come in, take his shot. He will then replace R3, and R3 will run to the box to sub out for the next player in line. And so we're actually going to have two players cutting both ways and shooting on both sides, and it's going to rep through it really, really quickly. And so we're going to get a ton of breakaway chances as well as great feeding opportunities from this low wing. And as we are finishing, we really want to make sure of a couple things. First, we really want our players to be using their fakes, near side, far side, twisters, BTBs, have them be original, have them be creative. Make sure that they are crossing the front of the goal as they shoot so that they will get the goalie to move. If you really want to make your goalies work, make sure that they are watching the feeder and that they are cutting off this pipe right here and that they actually move as the ball is passed inside versus just waiting for the player to catch it. We want to make it as realistic as possible for all of the players. Now, if we are in the second period, it's going to look a little bit different. Most importantly, the lines that these players line up in are going to be across the floor. And this is the way that I think that it's meant to be run, because we really have great offensive transition when we're in the second period because our bench is on their defensive half. So it's going to work the exact same way. D4 is going to cut to the goal. He is going to receive a pass from D2. He will come in. He will take his shot. Right as D2 passes it, he's going to run across the midline to this opposite bench. He's going to yell one. He's going to release D3, who's going to cut. He's going to receive a feed from R3. He'll take his shot. He's then going to refill for R3, which I didn't mention down here that he would do too. Right as R3 passes it, he's going to run across the floor to here, yell one, and release the next player. And so we're going to have this continuous cycle as we go. Here's a short clip of us running it in practice. Oh, sorry, I should have gotten you one. There you go, nice BTB fake. That was sick. Ryan, I'm gonna show you that later. Now Carson's gonna get off. He's gonna shoot. Now Lincoln's gonna have another pass. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like and subscribe button. Definitely let me know what you guys thought down in the comment section. And if you'd like to get the playbook PDF of this drill, you can get that at patreon.com/powlax by clicking this link up in the corner or the link in the description. And we're doing a lot more stuff on Facebook and Instagram now, and you can follow Powlax and Powlax Master Coach on both of those platforms. Have a good one. I'll see you guys in the next video.